You can make various desktop applications using the PyQt5 library in the Python programming language. In this video, we will make a text editor using the PyQt5 library in the Python programming language. The video consists of two parts. In the first part, we will understand how it works after transferring the project from GitHub to the computer. In the second part, we will examine the codes of the text editor application from the beginning with you. So let's start. You can download and develop the source codes of the project in this video from the Turtle Code GitHub account. Before starting the project, you can support us by following the Turtle Code YouTube channel and other social media accounts. There are several ways to transfer the project from GitHub to your computer. You can run the project codes after downloading them directly to your computer. In this video, we will transfer the project directly using the version control feature of the PyCharm application. In other coding applications, you can transfer the project directly from GitHub to your computer by using the version control feature. Copy the web address of the project. I will share the web address of the project with you in the description of the video. Paste the copied address in the version control panel. Click the clone button to start the transfer process. The transfer process will be completed in a short time. The transfer process has been completed. Run the code to find out how the project works. We made a simple text editor application. Enter some text and click the save button. The text document has been saved. In the second part, we will examine the codes of the text editor application from the beginning with you. You can create a desktop application using a few libraries such as Tkinter, Kivy in the Python programming language. In this project, we created a desktop application using the PyQt5 library. The files required to create a desktop application from the PyQt5 library have been transferred to the project. A class has been created. The options to be displayed when the button to close the application is clicked in the classroom are determined. It was stated that if the application close button is clicked and no changes are made in the text editor, the application will be closed without showing the closing options. If there is a change in the text editor, three options will be displayed as save, discard, and cancel. When the save button is clicked, the save function created in the project will be run and the text editor will be saved. When the cancel button is clicked, the changes made in the text editor will be ignored and the application will be closed. Create a variable and synchronize it with the application function. Set a title for the desktop project using the set application name function. Create a text variable and synchronize it with the plain text edit function. Create the window variable for the desktop window and synchronize it with the main window function. Place the text object in the center of the window. Set the file path to none. Create a variable for menu, add file menu to application options using menu bar and add menu functions. Add the open action to the file option. Create the open function. You can use the global keyword to use the variable created as none in the function. Create a variable and synchronize it with the file dialog function. If there is a path in the file path, synchronize the file path variable with the path variable. Sync with the open file function to assign a task when the open button is clicked. Use the set shortcut function to create a shortcut. Add the open action function you created to the options using the add action function. Create and sync a save action variable to save the project. If the file path is not specified yet, activate the save as function. If file path is specified, write the file name and set the change to false again. If you want to close the project without making any changes with this method, the project will be closed without showing the options. Synchronize the task function with the triggered and connect functions to assign a task when the save action button is clicked. Use the set shortcut function to create a shortcut. You can add the save option to the options section with the add action function. To save the text editor as, create a variable using the action function. Create a function called save as for saving as. In this function, you can use the file path variable in the function by using the global keyword. Create a variable using the file dialog function. If the path variable is active, synchronize it with the file path variable. Run the save function and start the process of saving the text editor. To assign a task when the save as button is clicked, sync it with the created function using the triggered and connect function. Use the window close function to close the text editor when the close option is selected, which created the close option with the action function. Add the close option to the project with the add action function. Add an option using the menu bar and add menu functions for help. For example, add about action to this option. Sync the option with the project using the add action function. Create a show about dialog function. In this function, you can specify the text to be displayed when the user selects the about option by synchronizing it with a variable. Synchronize the text to be displayed on the screen with the message box function. By using the triggered and connect functions, when the about button is clicked, you can display the text specified in the show about dialog function on the screen. Show the window on the screen using the show function. Use the exec function to close the project without an error when the close button is pressed. Run the project and enter some text. Save the text. In this video, we made a text editor application using the PyQt5 library in the Python programming language. Don't forget to develop the project after downloading it from GitHub. You can also watch the third part that I added extra to develop the project from scratch with me. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. You can also support us by subscribing to the Turtle Code YouTube channel and other social media accounts.